I wanted to give you four specific examples that I'm going to cover at the end about how a product called Silk tripled their sales by doing one thing, how an artist named Jeff Koons went from being a nobody to making a whole bunch of money and having a lot of impact, to how Frank Gehry redefined what it meant to be an architect, and one of my biggest failures as a marketer in the last few years, a record label I started that had a CD called Sauce. But before I can do that, I got to tell you about sliced bread and a guy named Otto Rohwedder. Now, before sliced bread was invented in the 1910s, I wonder what they said, like the greatest invention since the telegraph or something. But this guy named Otto Rohwedder invented sliced bread. And he focused, like most inventors did, on the patent part and the making part. And the thing about the invention of sliced bread is this, that for the first 15 years after sliced bread was available, no one bought it, no one knew about it. It was a complete and total failure. And the reason is that until Wonder came along and figured out how to spread the idea of sliced bread, no one wanted it. That the success of sliced bread, like the success of almost everything we've been talking about at this conference, is not always about what the patent is like or what the factory is like. It's about can you get your idea to spread or not. And I think that the way you're going to get what you want or cause the change that you want to change to happen is you're going to figure out a way to get your ideas to spread.
你的这个发明拿到专利也好，有一个工厂正在做这用这个方法生产也好，那个固然是基础的工作，固然重要，但是更重要的是说，你这个发明对于我今天一直在讲品牌的概念，就是说，对于消费者到底有什么意思？那一段如果没有沟通成功，那完全是没有意义的。因为消费者的心里面，对于这个切吐司面包的机器毫无兴趣。消费者的兴趣是在于吐司面包切成一块一块，对他有什么好处？这个这一段，对于你去发明了一个机器可以把吐司切成一块一块、一条一条切成整齐，它是没有兴趣的，因为它并没有要买你的股票，它的目的是要吃面包。那面包一大块，我拿回家自己切，跟你已经把它切好一块一块，那个之间对我有什么关系？ 是这一家叫做Wonder的这一家面包公司呢，它大量的去推广说，切成一片一片的面包比较好吃。那个我切的比你切的好吃，结果 ideas 大家相信了。为什么会相信？其实刚刚的那个瓶子的概念大家就看到了嘛。那个瓶子本身，你只看到第一眼你就对它产生好印象，其实那个沟通就是那个概念。再来说。 你看看他举的，他往下要举的几个例子 ，Starbucks， 还不是就是卖咖啡吗？那为什么他会经营的好呢？是沟通。他告诉你说，在这里喝咖啡比较对劲，对不对？那个对劲对每一个人的对劲都不一样哦。好，所以
，It doesn't matter to me。 Whether you're running a coffee shop or you're an intellectual or you're in business or flying hot air balloons, I think that all this stuff applies to everybody regardless of what we do. That what we are living in is a century of idea diffusion. That people who can spread ideas, regardless of what those ideas are, win.
听到了哈，意思就是说，你设计了一个很好的东西，你如果没有办法沟通那个。 设计，我们上星期讲的，你就不会有这一个星期我们要讲的重点，就不会有品牌，因为沟通的结果是品牌。你没有办法沟通，人家在脑袋里面怎么可能给你定位？如果人家在脑袋里面没有办法给你定位，那人家就不会给你一个品牌，好的品牌。所以，他叫做所有的能够把自己的概念成功的跟消费者去沟通的人，他才会真正的成功。
When I talk about, I usually pick business because they make the best pictures that you can put in your presentation and because it's the easiest sort of way to keep score. But I want you to forgive me when I use these examples because I'm talking about anything that you decide to spend your time to do. At the heart of spreading ideas is TV and stuff like TV. TV and mass media made it really easy to spread ideas in a certain way. I call it the TV industrial complex. And the way the TV industrial complex works is you buy some ads.
各位因为没有从事电视这个行业，所以很可能不太清楚他这一段在讲的事情。不过我建议大家很仔细的听一下这一段。这一段是在讲电视的这个产业，它如何的让那个我们把一个观念传播出去的这个方式呢，变得非常成功，而且非常容易。那么这个产业是怎么做到的
？Interrupt some people, that gets you distribution. You use the distribution you get to sell more products. You take the profit from that to buy more ads, and it goes around and around and around. The same way the military industrial complex worked a long time ago.
他的意思就是说，电视这个产业呢，它的生存的方式是电视有个节目，所以如果你要卖产品，你就去买一些广告时段。你买了一个广告时段，你就去一直不停的去打扰观众，让观众呢被你打扰的时候呢，你就因为他看到你的广告，他会去买你的东西，所以你就卖比较多的东西，卖比较多的东西你就赚钱，然后你赚到钱以后，你又买更多的广告，所以他就是说越来越转，越来越转。那电视这个生态是靠这样生存的，那设计产品或者是要卖产品或服务的人，也是靠着这个方式去做到的。但是就像是前几堂课我跟各位曾经说到，各位也许没有注意听或者是没有听懂那是什么意思，他今天要告诉大家说这个方式已经再见了。
That model of, and we heard it yesterday, if we could only get on the homepage of Google, if we could only figure out how to get promoted there, if we could only figure out how to grab that person by the throat and tell them about what we want to do, if we could do that, then everyone would pay attention, we would win. Well, this TV industrial complex informed my entire childhood and probably yours. I mean, all of these products succeeded because someone figured out how to touch people in a way that they weren't expecting, in a way they didn't necessarily want, with an ad over and over and over again until they bought it. And the thing that's happened is they canceled the TV industrial complex. That just over the last few years...
这一章的讯息是很重要的。我常常在跟很多的在媒体界的朋友说，电视这个产业是正在快速消失，跟报纸是一样的。现在报纸，我们说啊，报纸应该会消失，大概没有人会否认。可是当我们说电视会消失，大家还将想去相信的人大概不多。但是这一章至少你可以看到说，他在 TV 的这个产业上面画了一条线，叫做 cancelled。原因是为什么？因为 TV 用的方法是，我在看一个节目，你在看节目的时候把我中断。然后利用中断的时间，不停地在卖我东西，不断地讲，不断地讲，不断地讲。越有钱的厂商就买越多的时间，就不断地讲，不断地讲，不断地讲，用广告的方式去让你被他说服。
For the last few years, what anybody who markets anything has discovered is it's not working the way that it used to. This picture is really fuzzy. I apologize, I had a bad cold when I took it. But the product in the blue box in the center is my poster child, right? I go to the deli, I'm sick, I need to buy some medicine. The brand manager for that blue product spent $100 million trying to interrupt me in 1 year. $100 million interrupting me with TV commercials and magazine ads and spam and coupons and shelving allowances and spiffs. Also, I could ignore every single message. And I ignored every message because I don't have a pain reliever problem. I buy the stuff in the yellow box, I always have. And I'm not going to invest a minute of my time to solve her problem because I don't care.
这一段他刚刚说，我原来都没有感冒，所以我也没有头痛需要去买药的时间。所以那个蓝色的盒子的这个产品经理已经花了$1亿去打广告，我根本就没有理他。等到我有需要的时候，我跑到药店里去买的时候，我也没有买它，因为我买黄色的那个盒子。为什么我买黄色的盒子？因为我对那个黄色盒子比较习惯。所以那个花了$1亿，就等于白花了。他$1亿一直不停打，打了半天广告，但是他没有兴趣。 为什么他没有兴趣？
Here's a magazine called Hydrate. It's 180 pages about water. Right? Articles about water, ads about water. Imagine what the world was like 40 years ago when it was the Saturday Evening Post and Time and Newsweek. Now there are magazines about water. New product from Coke Japan, water salad. Okay? Coke Japan comes out with a new product every 3 weeks because they have no idea what's going to work and what's not. This, I couldn't have written this better myself. It came out 4 days ago. I circled the important parts so you can see them here. They've come out, Arby's is going to spend $85 million promoting an oven mitt with the voice of Tom Arnold, hoping that that will get people to go to Arby's and buy a roast beef sandwich. Now, I want you to try to imagine what could possibly be in an animated TV commercial featuring Tom Arnold that would get you to get in your car, drive across town, and buy a roast beef sandwich. You know, this is Copernicus, and he was right when he's talking to anyone who needs to hear your idea. The world revolves around me. Me, 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 my favorite person, me. I don't want to get email from anybody. I want to get me-mail. So consumers, and I don't just mean people who buy stuff at the Safeway. I mean people at the Defense Department who might buy something, or people at, you know, the New Yorker who might print your article. Consumers don't care about you at all. They just don't care. Part of the reason is they got way more choices than they used to and way less time.
这一张图也是很重要的一张，意思就是说，现在的消费者他所被提供的产品选择越来越多越来越多，像刚刚的那个感冒药，他越来越多越来越多，但是他的时间越来越少越来越少，所以时间越来越少，东西越来越多的时候，他有什么选择呢？他的选择是这样。
And in a world where we have too many choices and too little time, the obvious thing to do is just ignore stuff. And my parable here is you're driving down the road and you see a cow and you keep driving. Because you've seen cows before, cows are invisible, cows are boring. Who's going to stop and pull over and say, oh, look, a cow? Nobody. But if the cow was purple, isn't that a great special effect? I could do that again if you wanted. If the cow was purple, you'd notice it for a while. I mean, if all cows are purple, then you'd get bored with those too. The thing that's going to decide what gets talked about, what gets done, what gets changed, what gets purchased, what gets built is it remarkable? And remarkable is a really cool word because we think it just means neat, but it also means worth making a remark about. And that is the essence of where idea diffusion is going. That two of the hottest cars in the United States is a $55,000 giant car, big enough to hold a Mini in its trunk. People are paying full price for both, and the only thing they have in common is that they don't have anything in common. Every week, the number one best-selling DVD in America changes. It's never The Godfather, it's never Citizen Kane, it's always some third-rate movie with some second-rate star. But the reason it's number one is because that's the week it came out. Because it's new, because it's fresh, because people saw it and said, I didn't know that was there, and they notice it. Two of the big success stories the last 20 years in retail. One sells things that are super expensive in a blue box, and one sells things that are as cheap.
They can make them.
这个他说过去20年最成功的两个这个零售店，一个是用蓝色的盒子装的卖很贵东西，他是讲 Tiffany， 另外一个就是 Walmart。它是卖的很便宜的东西，所以卖得好卖得不好跟卖得贵卖得不贵其实没有关系，有卖得很便宜卖得很好，有卖得很贵卖得很好，所以他们的共同点就是他跟别人不同。
As they can make them, the only thing they have in common is that they're different. We're now in the fashion business. No matter what we do for a living, we're in the fashion business. And the thing is, people in the fashion business know what it's like to be in the fashion business. They're used to it. The rest of us have to figure out how to think that way, how to understand that it's not about interrupting people with big full-page ads or insisting on meetings with people, but it's a totally different sort of process that determines which ideas spread and which ones don't. This chair, they sold $1 billion worth of Aeron chairs by reinventing what it meant to sell a chair. They turned a chair from something the purchasing department bought to something that was a status symbol about where you sat at work. This guy, Lionel Poulain, the most famous baker in the world, he died 2.5 months ago, and he was a hero of mine and a dear friend. He lived in Paris. Last year, he sold $10 million worth of French bread, every loaf baked in a bakery he owned by one baker at a time in a wood-fired oven. And when Lionel started his bakery, the French poo-pooed it. They didn't want to buy his bread. It didn't look like French bread. It wasn't what they expected. It was neat, it was remarkable, and slowly it spread from one person to another person until finally it became the official bread of 3-star restaurants in Paris. Now he's in London and he ships by FedEx all around the world. What marketers used to do is make average products for average people. That's what mass marketing is. Smooth out the edges.
接下来这张图，它就要告诉大家说，以前我们常常讲大众行销，可是大众行销在我们现在这个世界来看是错的。大众行销只有在电视这个产业存在的时候，它是对的，因为电视是单向沟通，所以电视是不停的打广告，不停的打广告。但是现在是在网络上面，它讲究的是互动，互动就不可以用大众行销的那种轰炸机的方式去打。那所以，他利用这张图来跟我们说明。
Go for the center. That's the big market. They would ignore the geeks and, God forbid, the laggards. It was all about going for the center. But in a world where the TV industrial complex is broken, I don't think that's the strategy we want to use anymore. I think the strategy we want to use is to not market to these people because they're really good at ignoring you, but market to these people because they care. These are the people who are obsessed with something. And when you talk to them, they'll listen because they like listening. It's about them. And if you're lucky, they'll tell their friends on the rest of the curve and it'll spread. It'll spread through the entire curve. They have something I call otaku. It's a great Japanese word. It describes the desire of someone who's obsessed to, say, drive across Tokyo to try a new ramen noodle place because that's what they do. They get obsessed with it. To make a product, to market an idea, to come up with any problem you want to solve that doesn't have a constituency within otaku is almost impossible. Instead, you have to find a group that really desperately cares about what it is you have to say, talk to them, and make it easy for them to tell your friends. There's a hot sauce otaku, but there's no mustard otaku. That's why there's lots and lots and lots of kinds of hot sauces and not so many kinds of mustard. Not because it's hard to make interesting mustard. You can make interesting mustard. But people don't because no one's obsessed with it, and thus no one tells their friends. Krispy Kreme has figured this whole thing out. Krispy Kreme has a strategy. And what they do is they enter a city, they talk to the people with the otaku, and then they spread through the city to the people who have just crossed the street. This yo-yo right here costs $112, but it sleeps for 12 minutes. Not everybody wants it, but they don't care. They want to talk to the people who do, and maybe it'll spread. These guys make the loudest car stereo in the world. It's as loud as a 747 jet. You can't get in. The car's got bulletproof glass on the windows because they'll blow out the windshield otherwise. But the fact remains that when someone wants to put a couple speakers in their car, if they've got the otaku or they've heard from someone who does, they go ahead and they pick this. It's really simple. You sell to people who are listening, and maybe, just maybe, those people tell their friends. So when Steve Jobs talks to 50,000 people at his keynote, right, who are all tuned in from 130 countries watching his 2-hour commercial, that's the only thing keeping his company in business, is that those 50,000 people care desperately enough to watch a 2-hour commercial and then tell their friends. Pearl Jam, 96 albums released in the last 2 years, everyone made a profit. How? They only sell them on their website. Those people who buy them on their website have the otaku, and then they tell their friends, and it spreads, and it spreads. This hospital crib costs $10,000, 10 times the standard. But hospitals are buying it faster than any other model. Hard candy nail polish doesn't appeal to everybody, but to the people who love it, they talk about it like crazy. This paint can right here, Save the Dutch Boy Paint Company, making them a fortune, costs 35% more than regular paint, because Dutch Boy made a can that people talk about, because it's remarkable. They didn't just slap a new ad on the product, they changed what it meant to build a paint product. AmIHotOrNot.com. Every day, 250,000 people go to this site, run by two volunteers. And I can tell you, they're hard graders. And they didn't get this way by advertising a lot. They got this way by being remarkable, sometimes a little too remarkable. And this picture frame has a cord going out the back, and you plug it into the wall. My father has this on his desk, and he sees his grandchildren every day, changing constantly. And every single person who walks into his office hears the whole story of how this thing ended up on his desk. And one person at a time, the idea spreads. These are not diamonds. Not really. They're made from cremains. After you get cremated, you can have yourself made into a gem. Oh, you like my ring? It's my grandmother. Fastest growing business in the whole mortuary industry. But you don't have to be Ozzy Osbourne. You don't have to be super outrageous to do this. What you have to do is figure out what people really want and give it to them. A couple quick rules to wrap up. The first one is design is free when you get to scale. And the people who come up with stuff that's remarkable more often than not figure out how to put design to work for them. Number two, the riskiest thing you can do now is be safe. Procter & Gamble knows this, right? The whole model of being Procter & Gamble is always about average products for average people.
这一句也是很重要的，就是最危险的路，那么这也是我们前几堂课说，大公司通常都希望大家分析一个最安全的办法。那但是最安全的方法，在现在的这个世界里面，它是提供一种普通的产品卖给普通的人，普通的产品卖给普通的人呢，就是表示大家都很容易忽略你的产品。那么这样子的一个经营的方式，在21世纪行得通，在21世纪已经行不通。所以 safe is risky 这句话呢，是他的这个演讲里面很重要的一个概念。
Procter & Gamble is always about average products for average people. That's risky. The safe thing to do now is to be at the fringes, be remarkable. And being very good is one of the worst things you can possibly do. Very good is boring. Very good is average. It doesn't matter whether you're making a record album, or you're an architect, or you have a tract on sociology. If it's very good, it's not going to work.
他刚刚说，为什么说做得很好是很普通的？我有一次跟台湾的一位做电脑的朋友在聊天，他说现在不管你全世界哪一个牌子的 PC， 基本上就是在台湾做的。那在台湾做的所有的这些 PC 的产品，基本上控制的制作流程都一样，成本都差不多，所以你不管买哪一个，其实都差不多，一样好一样的东西，所以它只能卖很便宜，因为大家都一样，一样的做得很好，一样做得很好，就是没什么意思了。所以他说 ，very good is boring 的意思不是说 很好是不对的，把它做烂不是这个意思，是说你只有做到很好，像我们的电脑产品一样，做到很好，怎样呢？做到很好，因为每一个人都做得很好的时候，你就变成 boring，所以做到很好是不够的。Because
no one's going to notice it. So my three stories: Silk put a product that does not need to be in the refrigerated section next to the milk in the refrigerated section. Sales tripled. Why? Milk, 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 not milk. Right? For the people who were there and looking at that section, it was remarkable. They didn't triple their sales with advertising. They tripled it by doing something remarkable. That is a remarkable piece of art. You don't have to like it, but a 40-foot tall dog made out of bushes in the middle of New York City is remarkable. Frank Gehry didn't just change a museum, he changed an entire city's economy by designing one building that people from all over the world went to see. Now, at countless meetings at, you know, the Portland City Council or who knows where, they say, we need an architect. Can we get Frank Gehry? Right? Because he did something that was at the fringes. And my big failure, I came out with an entire, a record album, and hopefully a whole bunch of record albums, in SACD format, this remarkable new format, and I marketed it straight to people with $20,000 stereos. People with $20,000 stereos don't like new music. So what you need to do is figure out who does care. Who is going to raise their hand and say, I want to hear what you're doing next, and sell something to them. The last example I want to give you, this is a map of Soap Lake, Washington. As you can see, if that's nowhere, it's in the middle of it. But they do have a lake. And people used to come from miles around to swim in the lake. They don't anymore. So the founding fathers at Soap Lake said, we got some money to spend. What can we build here? And like most committees, they were going to build something pretty safe. And then an artist came to them. This is a true artist rendering. He wants to build a 55-foot tall lava lamp in the center of town. That's a purple cow. That's something worth noticing. I don't know about you, but if they build it, that's where I'm going to go. Thank you very much for your attention. I appreciate it.
Okay, 我们刚刚看了这位Seth Godin 的这个演讲呢，我想大概大家也就对他有一些了解，而且大概他要讲的概念，我们整理一遍。请问 Seth Godin 讲的内容重点有哪一些？怎么创造什么 ？Remarkable，OK。Okay. 你对 remarkable 的解释是什么？印象深刻的，与众不同，与众不同。Remarkable 这个字，等一下我们可以解释。Remarkable 里面有一个叫 remark， 对不对 ？Remark 意思就是说评论。那因为它值得 remark， 所以它是 remarkable。所以有一个东西一跑出来的时候，如果你连在你的部落格上去写一下他，把他骂一顿，你都懒得的话，他就一定死了。可是不管你把他骂一顿，还是把他称赞一顿，他都可能有机会，因为你在 remark 他，你在评论他。所以做一个东西出来，没有人 remark， 那就真的是没有办法了。啊？要显著。我帮各位整理了一下啊 ，Seth Godin 的重点，第一个是观念传播比专利生产重要。他在最早的时候说的，哦，就是观念传播事实上是最重要。你有了专利，你有了生产的技术，固然重要，但是你的这个观念传播不出去，这些专利跟生产所要生产出来的东西，它是没有办法变成人家的用品，因为它在别人的脑袋里面没有把它装到一个档案里面，说我喜欢它，所以它就这个观念是没有传播出去。第二个，电视模式的传播已经失效。我们如果现在出现一个产品，还觉得说我需要在电视上打广告，那就是表示你是非常落伍的想法。所以电视模式的传播已经失效。第三个，与我无关的事我会忽视，就是如果是跟你毫无关系，不管你怎么样子，这个对方怎么样子用力的去跟你沟通，其实你都会忽视。刚刚那个花$1亿广告的感冒药没有用，对他没有用，就是这个意思。与我无关的事我会忽视。大众传播目标都是找一般人，容易受到忽略。也就是说，你如果找的是那个曲线中间的那些人，他通常都会忽略你。中型曲线的两端才是沟通的对象，就是他刚刚的这一条曲线，他说一般现在传播都找中间，那个中间呢，事实上都是最容易忽略别人的人，有话题才能沟通。所以我们刚刚说 remarkable， 就是你必须要有话题，他才能够开始沟通。紫牛才有话题，一般的牛就没有话题。注意力经济时代，事多时间少，也就是说现在我们的这个需要去看的东西太多，被提供的选择太多，可是时间又变得很少，所以它就变成一个叫做注意力经济的时代。 注意力经济的时代呢，你必须要有找到话题才能够沟通，所以你的设计必须要成功的让有话题去沟通，才能够建构一个你想要别人得到的在他脑袋里面对你好的印象，也就是一个好的品牌。所以请你记住，值得注意的跟谈论、评论、注解都有 remark 这个英文字在里头，所以 remark 就是评论、谈论、去注解， remarkable 就是值得你去 remark 的事情。所以如果一件事情没有人评论，大家都说嗯，好好好，不错不错，都没有去骂他或者是赞叹他或者是去解释他的话，他大概就是不值得注意的，不值得注意的就不会形成一个品牌。这个是一个有趣的指牛，就是贝聿铭先生的这个罗浮宫的大门的这个金字塔的设计。这个金字塔要设计的时候是大家骂得要命，那个时候几乎都快要盖不起来，所以他是从非常不满意的评论到他终于盖好以后变成两倍观光客大家的讨论，他就是一个指牛。他如果配合的周遭的房子盖的跟周遭的房子像穿制服一样的一模一样，就在这里盖一个几乎相似的东西在这里，一定没有人骂，因为大家都会觉得本来就应该这样子，很搭配，很协调，大概评审委员都会拍拍手很高兴。可是他在做这栋房子的时候是评审全部反对的，在评审全部反对的时候，那时候只有一个人坚持要让他这样做，就是那时候的法国总统密特朗。密特朗坚持说让他做这个东西，但是那个时候的文化部长，法国文化部长是非常非常反对。贝先生的事务所为了沟通这件事情，还拿了一个起重机，把四条绳子从这里掉下来，从这里掉下来，从这里掉下来。起重机是吊的一个绳子，这样吊，这样吊，这样吊，让大家去看看说这个金字塔盖起来的时候，它会对这个产生什么影响。到这个《达文西密码》那部电影去看过的人举手，我看。《达文西密码》。哇，这么少人看，好可怜啊！《达文西密码》是拿这个地方做故事的背景，那个警察在看这栋房子的时候，他还是说他像法国巴黎身上的一个刀疤，意思就是说他是丑得要命。可是不管怎么样子，他证明了他的两倍观光客，他从罗浮宫不太有人爱去到变成很多人爱去的原因，就是它是 purple cow， 它是紫牛。所以你到现在你还是可以不喜欢它，你说我喜欢盖的一模一样，那你去盖的一模一样的时候，你就不会有那个两倍的观光客。所以除非现在罗浮宫他希望是还是继续没有人去看，他就必须有这样子的 entryway。 所以我们现在在谈的东西不是在谈设计要怎样变成叫做 good quality， 因为 good quality 的设计已经叫做一个 must。 刚刚他已经说了 very good 是你本来就应该 very good， 但是只有做到 very good， 像我们做的电脑，台湾做的电脑做得这么好，怎么样呢？叫做 boring， 因为大家都一样好，所以就是 boring。 那所以你就必须要 remarkable， 那这个 remarkable大概用这个东西做例子是很好的例子，因为它不断的被骂，可是它不断的吸引人去，所以这个事情呢就可以看得到，如果你这位创作者很怕挨骂，你大概做不出什么好东西。但是如果你想要去挨骂，你还要看你有没有那个能力撑得过去，因为贝先生那时候的事务所的很多人其实都在简报的时候都是被骂哭了，所以不是说那么大的事务所就不会挨骂，他是被骂哭的，但是他就是坚定的照着他的想法去把它做完。等到他做完的时候，他真正的吸引到很多人。我看过一个纪录片，贝先生从那个楼梯，他站在一个边边的地方，就看到很多人来来往往的时候，我相信他那时候的心里面是很安慰的，因为他知道他的很多年前的 dream 他已经把它落实。那种东西通常这种创作是非常寂寞的，因为 你被骂，所以才有机会做出来。那这个是一个非常重要的，作为一个设计者必须要去了解。如果你想要 play safe， 那它就是最不安全的东西，就是因为你这个很安全做出来的事情，到最后不会 remarkable。另外一个他跟我们讲的就是说，所有的产业都是流行产业，必须要重新定义才会有利润。那这些他都已经说过了，我只是替大家做点笔记，所以我就不再重复。